Final instructions from our referee, Atsushi Onari. We are set for 3 rounds, 1 Super Series kickboxing rules contest. In front of a sellout crowd inside the Singapore indoor stadium. Where Giorgio Petrosyan has more muscles than a seafood buffet. He is looking in the best shape we've seen him in a long time. This one brought to you by Global Citizen. Petrosyan, the southpaw. High right roundhouse kick. That's the power weapon of Sorgraw.
This is when Sorgraw needs to jump on Petrosyan. Petrosyan hasn't figured out his rhythm yet, hasn't figured out his timing. This is Sorgraw's moment.
I think Lynch, he might have just figured it out. That was a beautiful combination there. Sorgraw with the Pratchett armbands around his biceps. Out of the mini traditions and superstitions surrounding the ancient martial art of Muay Thai, more than 3,000 years old.
Petrosyan's throwing heat with those hands.
The little quarter turns, everything thrown with surgical precision. That's why they call him the doctor. And again, Petrosyan, the hand, the step through knee. Just a delight to behold. And Sorgraw's got to start winding up that right roundhouse kick. Petrosyan resets. The man who fled Armenia during its war-torn years, relocated to Italy, had to sleep on the streets with his father and his younger brother, living out of train stations, out of gutters, overcame abject poverty to today be arguably the greatest combat stylist in the world. Oh, beautiful right hand there from Petrosyan. And that'll give Sorgraw a headache.
Petrosyan's at it. Like, this is a different game. He's being much more aggressive. He's going first. He's not letting Sorgraw go. He's actually looking for the knockout in the very first round.
Petrosyan, who lives in Milan these days, close friends with Italian soccer striker Mario Balotelli, no doubt watching his close friend at the moment. Putting on a fine display of finesse, the Ferrari of kickboxing, Giorgio Petrosyan. Began his pro career some 15 years ago. Two-time K1 Max champion, looking for win number 98 tonight. Uppercut to a left hand. Petrosyan in control early. The chin is tucked, looking through the brow. You can see the right leg is cocked.
Oh, Sorgraw! The big kibosh! Here comes Petrosyan! Sorgraw from the legs, he's right for the picking! Petrosyan takes his time, finds his opening.
And Sorgraw still not composed. The butterflies are still around his eyes. Petrosyan backs him up again. The doctor doing surgery. Lands the left hand, the power hand, and once more for Petrosyan. Absolute ownership of Sorgraw. You can sign the pink slip right now.
Sorgraw seems pleased with himself that round. I'm not quite sure why, because that was a very aggressive start for Petrosyan. He missed right there, but I think he was starting to figure out that timing. Came forward aggressively. There was that big left hook. That's what caught Sorgraw, and then he just jumps all over him, finding some big shots, hunting after Sorgraw. He's scoring over the top, landing some big shots. Big miss right there from Sorgraw. Very impressive round for the doctor.
Petrosyan said in his three-month camp he studied as much video as he could find on Sorgraw. He said, the only thing I've got to watch out for were his leg kicks. But he said, I beat Sorgraw everywhere. Sorgraw had a six-week camp. Very prodigious talent. Was born in Buriram, Thailand, about 400 kilometers northeast of Bangkok. Relocated from Buriram to Bangkok as a 15-year-old to further his Muay Thai career. Lumpini welterweight champion, two-time world champion. And here he is in the biggest challenge of his life against the greatest, Giorgio Petrosyan, who almost dropped him in the opening round. Good forearms guard against the roundhouse kick there. Petrosyan, that left-hand cross, it is sublime. He leans back like Fat Joe. Tremendous evasion.
you know, you said Petrosyan was, you know, the only thing he had to worry about was the leg kicks, but Sorgraw hasn't really thrown a lot of leg kicks. He hasn't attacked that inside lead leg.
After he
said that, he just goes after
it. One way to slow down an opponent's punching, an opponent's boxing, is to kick the legs.
The only thing he's thrown is he's thrown that rear leg ground kick. Oh, he caught one right there.
Every time Sorgraw gets backed against the fence, Petrosyan punishes him with speed and precision.
Sorgraw's throwing that right kick, but Petrosyan's eating it on his arms, which would slow down the hands.
Oh, the uppercut, like the straight left cross. With timing like that, Giorgio Petrosyan shouldn't be Italian. He should be Swiss. Again with the lead right. Petrosyan the overhand to the top of the noggin.
It's that right hook, Michael. That's the one. That's the one that's catching Sorgraw over and over again. And it's setting up that straight left hand.
Petrosyan, left cross down the tube. Again as Sorgraw drifts back against the cage. Petrosyan makes him pay for it. 1:33 remaining, second round of three. First round all Petrosyan. So too here in the second. Good forearms guard against the roundhouse kick. Two punch combination. The evasion from the counter striking. Everything is flawless at the moment from Giorgio Petrosyan. Uppercut again. The ripped, stripped, and shredded arms, deltoids, biceps, triceps of Petrosyan in tremendous physical shape. Again, he lands the cross off the left. There's the jab. He's had more jabs than a pin cushion tonight, Giorgio Petrosyan. What can Sorgraw do here, Mitch?
Man,
how does he combat this?
Man, I don't know. He has to find a way to slow down Petrosyan, because Petrosyan is just marching forward. He has absolutely zero respect for Sorgraw's power.
Step Brunei from Sorgraw. That won't do the trick. Petrosyan drifts back to center cage. Two-punch combination. Again, it is a treat. It is a show. It is kickboxing 101 from Giorgio Petrosyan.
Man, that could be the best two-punch combo I've ever seen. That hook to straight left hand is precision.
You know, I spoke to Demetrius Johnson yesterday, and he said on the entire card tonight, the man who was most looking forward to watching live for the first time ever was Giorgio Petrosyan. Both him and Eddie Alvarez singled out Petrosyan as the man they most wanted to watch cageside tonight.
For this exact reason. And now the doctor, who is known for precision, is starting to hit with tremendous power. Let's look at some of the handiwork. Look at the way Petrosyan picks these shots. There, he goes right down the middle first with the straight left hand, and then he adds those hands behind it. I want to see the uppercut. Oh, just on cue. Beautiful timing on that. Boom. Caught him with a wonderful uppercut off the lead side, and then look at that. Evades the right hook, counters back. Just a clinic put on by the doctor.
Giorgio Petrosyan makes it look so damn easy. Very calm, focused, relaxed. Petrosyan hasn't put a glove, a foot, a knee out of place. His timing has been exquisite. His power has been superb. 3 minutes remaining in front of a sellout crowd here in Singapore. Can Sorgraw, the Indie Academy, find something to upset the greatest?
Barely broken a sweat. Not breathing hard, seems completely relaxed, no different from the first round to the third.
That defense, the way he puts up that wall from his legs up to his forearm, protecting all that side of his body where the right roundhouse kicks are coming from Sorgraw. And there it is again, the total package here. Giorgio Petrosyan comes forward. Beautiful jab. You see the jab and immediately takes his chin out of range for a possible counter. It's the minuteness, the little things of Petrosyan, the little intricacies you've got to watch. You've got to applaud. You've got to absolutely love. And again, that left-hand cross thrown as a lead. There's the old 3-2, the hook to the cross from Petrosyan. 3-2 again. There's the hook from Petrosyan once more. There's the cross.
Petrosyan drifts back to center cage. Sorgraw goes down to the legs, maybe should have gone there a little more tonight. Another two punch combination. Petrosyan locks him up, and referee, oh, now he breaks them. Haven't seen Sorgraw move in for the grapple. Under these kickboxing rules, you are allowed to clinch for 3 seconds and throw as many knees as you like. Haven't seen Sorgraw, who's a Muay Thai champion, go that route.
Not just a regular Muay Thai champion, not just a regular Muay Thai world champion, a Lumpini world champion, and Petrosyan is having his way with him.
Mitch, you couldn't have said it better. Petrosyan is using him as a chew toy. Just absolutely owning Sorgraw here. It is another beautiful display. And you can see why ONE Super Series has become the premier striking organization on the planet. You saw Muay Thai earlier tonight, you see Petrosyan here, you saw Smoke and Joe Nuttawa. We've got Godson Pai coming up again soon. All the great names in the world are with ONE Super Series, and you are seeing the greatest of all at it again. 45 seconds remaining. I wish we had another 25 minutes on this one to watch Giorgio Petrosyan at work.
Man, but how tough is Sorgraw? He has taken Petrosyan's best shots, which we have described as powerful, precision, possibly perfect. He really just taking his best shot, answered, still biting down those mouthpiece, ready to throw down. Literally right there.
Mitch, as I glance around here, it's a very silent crowd for this one, not because they've left to get a drink, because everyone's on the edge of their seats with their mouth ajar, beholding what Giorgio Petrosyan is showing them. A very highly educated combat crowd here in Singapore are loving every second of this. This is like watching Da Vinci paint in front of you. It's incredible. That was another masterclass display. There is no doubt in your mind, I'm sure, as in ours, that Petrosyan gets it. They're Victor Greer alongside Hinto Gracie, the stars out in fourth. And I'll tell you what, they love themselves some Giorgio Petrosyan.
Let's take a look at the hands of Petrosyan. Look at that. Opens up with a lead right hook and comes right down the middle with the straight left hand. His money shot all night long has been that left hand. Just an absolute battering ram, a trip hammer, just coming right through the middle, connecting over and over again. Very impressive. Very impressive striking display.
We go down to the judges. Petrosyan hardly raising a sweat. He looks to be in the best shape I've ever seen him. My word. Let's go to Dominic Glau.
To present the medal for this match, we have KT Farha, Senior Director of Business Development, Global Citizen. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Giorgio Petrosyan.
It is yet another win from Giorgio Petrosyan, the greatest of all time. Just showed us all why. Flawless, untouched, unblemished, incredible. The winner's medal goes back to Italy, around the neck of Petrosyan. And that's career victory number 98.